sun steps down and escapes the day. We'll calmly walk away from the fray. When structure falls and all else fails, we will build it once again.
Time for the show, no need to fear. Welcome to the fam, feel free to chat. Coming in strong like a running back. There's only one rule, don't be a troll. Or the rock gonna come and let you know you roll. Mop going in, going all the nothing. Don't forget to hit the follow button. Mops' crew got all the swagger. Spamming the room with all the cappers. Taco Bell, Taco Supreme. Keep your eyes open for a secret stream. Hang a while, never overstayed. Every now and then mistakes are made. Looking for entertainment to look no more. Best recognized is Mops 64. Yeah.
And here we are again. It is hump day. And I hope you are humping, I guess. Guys, hello. Welcome to the Strum. It's a Wednesday. And we are going to do Wednesday things, which is do the same thing we usually do. Just hang out and play video games. So I hope you guys... Well, I always greet you guys something good. I hope nothing bad's happening to y'all. We're going to go ahead and play this new game that I just downloaded, and it's got great reviews, and hopefully you guys can help me with this game. It's actually a game which people can help. First of all, let me go ahead and change the title of this. You guys might have heard of this game. It's called Thimbleweed Park. And if you are a fan of, what is it, Monster Island or, no, what's it called? It's one of those, if you guys remember Maniac Mansion from the NES days, it's that kind of game where you're solving crimes and stuff. But that is the kind of game that we're playing, and I invite you guys to stick around and watch me play this, because you may be the reason I may beat this game. Who knows? So let's go ahead, show you my... Well, actually, let me cut the music right here. get this going onto my little display. And thanks again for checking out this channel. If you are new to this channel, I just kind of do the stream thing and play games. So here we go. Thimbleweed Park, let's launch this. Let's have fun. Okay, and we are going to start a new game. So basically, we're here to solve crimes. So I'm probably not going to talk as much. I'm going casual, dude. Because I want a quicker experience. Hard, why am I going to stress myself out? We'll do the hard mode once we get used to this mode. How about that? So basically, you interact with characters and objects here. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Give commands. Items your character has already picked up. Simple commands start with the verb and end with an object character. Okay. Okay, we're good. Let's start this. Seems very interesting. This is like sounds like one of those games I would definitely play. Just a light post. Going in and out. Looks like one of those airplane ones. Let the planes know that there's something there. Ooh. Rattling lock. Interesting. Thimbleweed Park, city limit, population 81, elevation 14. Oh. Oh. Okay, minus one. That was unexpected. All right. A bridge. Huh. A bum underneath the bridge. A hobo or whatever you call it. Drink away, my friend. Drink away.
I fly halfway around the world and an odd note is waiting for me in my hotel room. It says to come to the bridge down by the river.
Huh.
This looks like the place.
Huh. You
I could
think?
Really go for some Wiener Schnitzel after the long walk out here.
Wiener Schnitzel? Yeah.
I am supposed to meet someone down here. Have you seen anyone?
Do you have any whiskey?
Are you sure you have not seen anyone?
I'm just gonna keep bugging this guy.
I'm glad Chuck is dead. Ruined my life.
What?
Wake up, sir. I have to go. Sleep well.
Let's walk to the sign. Look at
Trestle Trail to Thimbleweed Park, 1.7 miles.
Okay, so oh god, I have instructions. Awesome. There. Okay, turn off the light above the trestle sign, so I know you have arrived. Okay. Is there a sign there?
It is too hot to touch.
Use light?
I do not see a way to turn it off.
Close light.
I do not see a way to turn it off. I wonder how I can turn off the light to let them know I'm here. Must be something around here that can help.
Pick up rock.
I wonder if I can use this rock to put out the light. I do not see a way to turn it off. It is a rock.
It is a... Use rock. God, that's like violent. I mean, that's against
there,
the law.
I've completed step three of the note. Now for step four.
Oh yeah, step four. Meet me at the large entrance to the underground sewers. Jeez. Could it be any more shadier? And we are walking. Did I just get smacked? That's not cool. All that so I could die? That's... Ugh. Yeah, you'd probably find me dead. Achievement! Is this where I do like that CSI stuff?
So tell me again why you're here.
I was assigned to the case by the home office in Albuquerque.
There is no home office in Albuquerque.
It's neat to know.
Look, I like working a case alone. I especially don't need some junior agent messing up my investigation. Especially some junior agent that thinks I don't know there isn't a home office in Albuquerque. So stay out of my way. Take a lot of notes. Sit back and learn. And I'll wrap up this case and we can both get the hell out of here.
Your reputation certainly precedes you, Agent Ray.
I'll take that as a compliment, Agent Reyes.
It's how it was intended.
I'm sure it was. Let's photograph the victim and head into town to talk to the local sheriff. The body is starting to pixelate.
Body starting to
what a bunch of goofs.
This is going to be a long night.
Look at.
Appears to be a male, approximately 40 years old. Looks like he's been in the water for 24 hours. You can tell by the pixelation around the nose and neck. Let's see here. There's no wallet.
What's
in his
up, Jed? Thanks for the host, man. Thank you.
Possibly a key card from a hotel.
Maybe I should put this on. Okay, let's look at the notebook. Appears to be male, approximately 40 years old. Looks like he's been in the water. Nothing in his pockets. Blah, blah, blah. How you doing, Jed? Look at this.
Detective Angela Ray, senior agent. It's a hotel key card from the dead man.
Let's look at the key card.
It's a hotel key card from the dead man.
Thank you, dude. Did you get your MLB, dude? Wait, how, why? What happened to your back, dude? What happened?
It's a cell phone. It's an instant camera, but there's no film in it. Oh. That's the coroner's job.
Push the corpse.
Better not. I don't want to turn the body over. That's the coroner's job.
Okay, the hole in the victim's head doesn't look like a gunshot, more like a puncture from a sharp object. His suit looks tailored, possibly European in design. What happened, Sticks, with the back, though? What exactly happened? Let's talk to... Whoa, what's she doing? Look at sign.
The bulb's broken.
Walk to corpse. Let's talk to the corpse. That's not gonna happen. Aw, damn, man. Did you get your game? Maybe we could walk over to the hobo.
It's a gate to the trail above.
Oh, it's gonna be...
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
Oh, wait, we don't have film. Okay, let's just use...
There's no film in the camera.
Great. Use cell phone. Let's try.
The cell phone has no reception.
Okay, that's not working here.
It's a hotel keycard from the dead man. It's a hotel keycard from the dead man.
Okay, what can we do? This...
Trestle Trail to Thimbleweed Park, 1.7 miles.
Okay, what do you think we should do? Oh, let's use him. Okay, nothing, So we switch characters.
There appears to be a small hole in the back of the head, origins unknown. The hole in the victim's head doesn't look like a gunshot.
Oh my god, let's
more
use...
More like a puncture from a sharp object. Which is odd, because the opening title sequence clearly showed a gunshot with accompanying sound effects.
This is part, it says the opening title started with a gunshot. Use in... No. Give Polaroid film to her, because...
Sure, I'll carry your
Okay, I'm starting to get this now. So let's use Polaroid film with the camera. And let's use the Polaroid camera on corpse. There we go.
Smile.
All right, smile.
Now we can head into town and find the local sheriff.
Yay!
It's a good photo of the body. I like how the state-of-the-art camera can alter the angle of the shot.
What? What is she saying? We're getting out of here. Open the gate. We're out of here. Right-click to execute the highlighted verb. Oh, okay. Hold down the left button to get your character following the cursor around. Okay, we got this. We got this.
It's a trail down to the railroad trestle.
Walk.
I don't see anything up ahead. I think the town must be in the
other direction.
Oh,
wait. There's a can here. We have something here. I like these games where you actually... A tuna can.
Is an empty can of Crockford's tuna heads the good parts. Is an empty can of Crockford's tuna heads the good parts. Dell has that fishy tuna head smell it's famous for.
Okay, we brought that. Okay, let's just walk away. Wait.
Signals are very strong tonight.
What are these guys?
Why are you dressed like a giant pigeon?
We're the Pigeon Brothers Plumbing. I'm Beth. That's my sister Emily.
Hi there.
But remember, signals are very strong tonight.
Signals?
What signals?
The signals. Signals are very strong tonight.
What a bunch of weirdos, man.
Why brothers if you're sisters?
Dad was expecting to have sons. And it was too cheap to have the van repainted. So we're just rolling with it till he's dead.
Oh, soon.
Shut up, Emily. Signals are very strong tonight.
Yes, you already said that. But what signals?
Why are they, like, weird?
I'm just screwing with you. Dark night. Deserted road. Me in a giant pigeon costume. It was too good to pass up. But the signals are strong tonight.
Okay,
very
these guys are weird.
Strong.
Nutcases.
You almost ran over a federal agent. That's a felony.
Sorry about that. Like I said, the signals are very strong tonight.
This is really odd. Should I save my game?
I wouldn't worry about it. The game was expertly designed to have no dead ends or death. Yet still be scary and have a sense of tension.
Okay.
You can feel safe exploring whatever you want.
But
I'd watch out for the signals. They can be very strong and disrupt the power grid.
Oh, gosh.
I think I've had enough of you. I need to find the sheriff and solve a murder.
Nice talking to you, too. Whack! Click, 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 click.
Click. I said walk. Click, 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 click.
It's a circus flyer with a crazy-looking clown on it. Pretty good makeup, though.
Okay, we got that. We don't...
Click, click, click. Was... Squeak!
No need. The perps are outside.
Click, 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 click. Eek!
What the? That's weird. Oh, cemetery. Crazy drivers.
We should go find the sheriff.
I guess we're gonna find the sheriff. Whatever. And we're going to town. Someone watching me by surveillance?
Wait for me.
Oh, I forgot about that guy.
Howdy.
What's up, man?
I'm the Thimbleweed.
That's a sheriff.
Sheriff. I don't remember calling the Federinos.
What's up,
that's
Spark?
What you are, feds. Hard to miss the government issue suits.
Nice, man. The three-man team. Sweet.
Damn straight, we're the feds.
Whoa! Hold your horse, Renos. No need to get snippy.
Snippy?
Looks like you heard about our little murder Reno out by the bridge, huh?
There is nothing little about murder, sir.
Ignore him. He's new.
No sense in wasting everyone's time, Reno.
This Who'd you play with,
dude? Is starting to get long, and it's only gonna get longer. Let's find the coroner and get you on your way. Wrestling starts at 8.
I hope it's he's like talking about on TV.
It's like
the coroner is waiting
today.
For you in his office. Come see me when you're done. I apologize, Areno, for all the lights being off. We don't stay open as long as you city slickerinos do at night.
Even for a murder?
Especially for murder.
For a murder?
That makes no sense.
Are we authorized to shoot people arenos?
Nice, Brummy Gamer. Sweet. Police Tron. Okay, let's use it. What does that do?
Breaker 19. Breaker, breaker.
Yeah, you blow that mic.
Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you.
What the?
A bicycle built for two.
Okay.
Attention, all units. Enough screwing around. I've got a case to solve.
Okay, so where is my little book? A restaurant. Walk to a drawer, open the drawer. Let's
just a bunch of files.
Okay, close. Can we open it? Can we mess with that? Okay, that didn't do much.
It's a good photo of the body. I like how the state-of-the-art camera can alter looks too complex to use without knowing more about it.
Okay. Walk to the radio. Let's use the radio.
We interrupt our hostile takeover non-stop music with this important message. You're listening to KSCUM 198.7 on your FM dial. All and right. Now back to our special hostile takeover song.
Sure. Look at the posters.
Wanted, Pickle Bill and the Cucumber Gang. Wanted. Huh? A meteor?
Oh, a meteor.
Wanted. Shady Jane and the Sunshine Gang.
Okay, there's like nothing here. Let's see
I
what
need
this guy
to stay
has.
Focused and solve.
Gotta give this guy a shot, too. Oh, here he is.
Howdy who, I'm the Thimbleweed Park Coroner.
It's the same dude.
Welcome to the future, who. Oh, these are the latest in crime-fighting computers made by Pillowtronics, Inc. This is all probably pretty advanced,
look at the feet right there.
Even for the Fedahoos.
Oh, do enlighten us.
Ooh, I love your sarcastic humor, Who, Agent Ray.
It's not humor.
There you go again.
We're interested in any help your computers can give us. They look marvelous.
They look marvelous.
Yes, happy to explain. So happy to explain, Who. Yeah, you might want to take notes.
Already on it.
Facetron.
Oh, tell us about the Facetron 3000.
The Facetron 3000. Or, as I like to call it.
Yeah. Let me guess. The Face Areno?
No, that's what the sheriff calls it. Yoo-hoo, city, Volcahoo, crack me up. Just insert two pictures of an individual and
okay,
it will verify
got that.
A positive match.
Tell us about the Fingertron 3000.
Put a
Rider
finger there?
Reno, the Fingertron 3000. Insert a fingerprint registry of known criminals and a fingerprint from the murder weapon on fingerprint tape, and it will do a match-a-hoo.
A match-a-hoo?
Tell us about the Bloodtron 3000.
This is the Bloodtron 3000. Put two bloody objects in, and it will match the blood type, printing out a report-a-hoo.
Alrighty, so...
Fascinating stuff. I think we've heard enough. This is all very impressive, sir. This should cut hours of our investigation.
Go see the sheriff in his office for a full explanation of the amazing Arrestron 3000. I have some paperwork to do, Who. Oh, yeah, almost forgot. These Tron machines are fully voice-activated, so if you need any information, just talk to them.
Okay.
It's like we're living in the futuristic year of 2017.
Well, that would make sense.
I hate this town.
Let's investigate these Tron machines, then go see the sheriff and get out of here.
Yeah, let's go. Let's do the Facetron thing. So we're gonna use this. Oh, it's working. So
the primary function of the Facetron 3000
this
is to analyze a photograph of a dead body and compare it with an official photographic ID to provide a positive identification
talks a lot.
Of the victim. Procure an official law enforcement camera, then to use camera with dead body. The Facetron 3000 trademark requires official government identification that contains a photograph of the victim.
Okay.
Sure. Whatever. Or submarine exit.
So if dude, it should have
impressive, but nothing happened.
Okay. There we go. So we have the... That's Ray's to-do list. I'm the girl, right? Fingerprint the murder weapon. Oh, okay. Let's do that. Yeah, we're going to... the sheriff's place. Open.
Hello again, Agent Areno.
Take the same dude.
Hopefully, the coroner fills you in on our state-of-the-art Areno computers.
That's some very serious computing power you've got there.
Yes, sir, Areno. It's all state-of-the-art computer Arenos from Pillowtronics. Absolutely infallible.
You, I mean, the coroner said something about the Arrestron?
Yes, the Arrestron 3000. The last step in a fully computerized Areno arrest. The final link in the chain of a guaranteed conviction Areno.
Okay.
Every detail Areno analyzed and verified by computer.
Moving on.
Right. Sorry, Areno. I get carried away sometimes. This is the big bad boy Areno you've been hearing about. The Arrestron 3000. Just feed three reports from other Tron machines into this, and it issues a 100% Areno valid arrest warrant. Yeah, these machines are the reason we need only one law enforcement officer Areno.
Ah.
Chuck said that computers will soon put us all out of work, allowing for a full life of luxury.
Who is this Chuck we keep hearing about?
Sadly, Chuck passed away a few days ago. There was a big service out at the cemetery, Areno. Oh, the entire town showed up, which isn't surprising for the hero of Thimbleweed County. We'll talk more about Chuck later. I need to run Areno and check on a disturbance call out at the old circus. Probably that stupid clown Areno again.
All right, let's go.
Looks like we need to go talk to the rest of the weirdos that live in this town.
Pretty much.
We should split up. It will be faster.
You cooling your heels in the local diner would also make things go faster.
If we follow agency questioning protocols, this shouldn't take long.
Just don't mess anything up. I want to get out of here as fast as possible.
Agreed.
Agreed. Okay, let's, well, can I talk to that? We'll do the control alt delete thing to see if that does anything.
Issue an arrest warrant for the obviously guilty suspect. Close program.
I feel lame now that we gave up that picture. What's those pigeon people again?
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
Can I do anything to help?
Well, the Hydrotron's tube is obviously burned out.
We could use a new one. A WC-67?
Yeah, we're out of that size.
Must have been the signals.
Yes, the signals.
Whatever. Oh, shoot. What's this?
It says... We're out of the old abandoned pillow factory. Back soon. Safely for savings, man.
Maybe we have to... Well, let's switch. Just go to Ray. We gotta go to his thing. Ray is... That's him. So we're going back. All we have to do is follow instructions. Should be good. Walk, 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 walk. Maybe we will find the weapon. Trestle Trail. Oh!
It's an empty whiskey bottle. It's an empty whiskey bottle. Definitely not the murder weapon.
Definitely
wrong
not.
Sized body hole.
That's right. We didn't explore down here. Oh?
Some type of knob or valve. Some type of knob or valve.
Okay, we're
looks rusty and immovable. A light switch. A light switch. If I turn it off, I can fumble around in the dark.
Yeah, why would
that sound fun? Looks like this valve has been welded into position forever.
Okay, this is getting interesting. Oh, dude, definitely could like find stuff here.
Looks like it's lost a couple of strings.
Huh.
I don't have a warrant for a badly tuned violin.
It's an ice pick.
That should
this
be.
This could be the murder weapon.
Okay, that's close.
These bags look like an adventure game red herring. My nose tells me that my eyes don't want to look at that.
Magic mushrooms.
I wonder if the authorities know about this. I'll just grab a little for later.
Yeah, there you go.
I don't want to pick that up.
This is a hobo's place.
It's a ton.
Anything here? Nothing. Fingerprint. Okay, we gotta fingerprint the weapon. Okay, we're going back. I guess we're going back to town. Can we fast book it to where we have to go? That'd be kind of cool. Gotta go. Luckily, it's not that far, dude. We'll just keep going.
Excuse me.
We're going to the sheriff's place. Wait, it was like back there. Whoops. Down here. Okay, so we're gonna use this.
This could be the murder weapon.
We should dust it for prints. It won't fit in the slot.
Dang it. How do we?
This could be the murder weapon. We should dust it for prints.
How do we dust it for prints? Talk to.
The primary function of the fingerprint 3000 trademark is to analyze a fingerprint and find a match in the registry of known criminals. And produce a report.
Notice MLB's 50% die. Still downloading. Sweet. You know what? I'm wondering why one of my timers isn't working. Okay, should be on now. It's like, why didn't it work before? Nice, almost there.
Entering hibernation state.
I need to fingerprint that freaking thing. Maybe up there? Talk to. How do I?
Close program.
This could be the murder weapon.
I need to fingerprint it. I don't know how to fingerprint it.
I'm already carrying it.
There's gotta be a place where I could like check that thing out.
This could be the murder weapon. We should dust it for prints.
I would like to dust it. How do you dust
it? I'm not putting my finger in there. It's a very dark and...
Okay, we'll go through the doors. Fingertron. It's on the Fingertron report. Damn it. I'm not using it right. Here, it's...
It won't fit in the slot.
But it's...
This could be the murder weapon. We should dust it for prints. I'm not putting my finger in there.
Come on.
I can't push that.
Walk.
Using official government issue fingerprint tape, place it on an object with fingerprints and the fingerprint will be transferred.
Where do I get that?
Using official government issue fingerprint tape, place it on an object with fingerprints and the fingerprint will be transferred.
Do I have that?
Entering hibernation state.
Detective and...
Okay... Where do I get the so-called tape? I gotta look around, don't I?
It's empty. It's an empty whiskey bottle. Definitely not the murder weapon. Wrong sized body hole. Lots of medical books there.
Uh-huh. Now I gotta find this tape?
Standard city issued desk, but with no drawers. There's a fingerprint book here.
Oh, hey!
This has fingerprints for everyone in Thimbleweed Park. Certified Fingertron 3000 compatible. Oh. This has fingerprints for everyone in Thimbleweed Park. Certified Fingertron 3000 compatible.
Okay, good, 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 good.
Just a bunch of files. This has fingerprints.
Okay, let's go in here. Maybe there's a way we could.
This could be the murder weapon. We should dust it for prints. It won't fit in the slot.
What is happening? Okay.
Using official government issue fingerprint tape, place it on an object with fingerprints and the fingerprint will be transferred. Hibernation state.
I don't know where to. Go back to the sheriff's thing. Walk over to vacuum.
Just a bunch of files.
Oh, I have to open everything.
Just a bunch of files.
Oh, okay, I think I get it. Let's go check here. Tape.
It's empty. There's a fingerprint kit here.
Oh, there we go.
There's a fingerprint brush, a small amount of fingerprint powder.
Yes!
But it's missing the fingerprint tape.
Damn! Why? How could it miss?
The prints are really clear.
So I need to...
It only accepts fingerprints on official fingerprint tape. It's already open. It's already open. It's already open.
Damn it. How could it be missing the freaking tape?
Just a bunch of files. Just a bunch of files. It's already open. It's already open.
Okay, nothing there. There's no more places.
It doesn't have any buttons.
No.
Must be for incoming calls only. I don't want to pick that up.
Guess we have to really search the town to get that other crap. Drink away. I could make noises for this.
I still have the brush, but no more fingerprint powder, and it's missing the fingerprint tape. The prints are really clear.
Shady.
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
Gotta go. I've got a murder to solve. I can't get past. I can't. The prints are really clear.
Everything's closed. Going down the outskirts. Now it rings.
Hello, Reno.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It is quite annoying.
No, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, they will be taken care of.
Yes, sir. Permanently.
See, he's
oh,
in it.
Yes, sir. Violently.
Uh-oh.
No, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, wrestling was quite good tonight. Goodbye, sir.
Like the wrestling references.
Welcome to Quickie Pal. Can I help you find anything? Hi there, I'm Quickie Pal Leonard. How can I help you?
A dead rat there.
I'm Junior Special Agent Reyes.
I'm not Holden, if that's what you're thinking. Tell me a bit about yourself, Leonard. Dude, how do you know my name? Are you, like, telepathic or something?
No. You just told me your name, and it's also on your name tag. Do you know anything about the body by the river?
No, but I heard the sheriff nearly ralphed when he saw it. The only bods I've seen lately are the righteous babes on the top shelf of the magazine rack.
Let's not go there.
Let's go.
I'm going to look around your store.
man-eating plant.
Let me know if I can help you with anything. I'm here to serve.
Yeah, nothing there. Movietron beta rent beta? I need to find that tape.
Welcome to the S&D Diner. Hey, just so you know, that article in the Thimbleweed Nickel about botulism was a smear job. So, what can I do for you, honey?
I'm a federal agent. Know anything about the dead body?
Not too much, just scuttlebutt from the morning breakfast crowd. And I don't want to get into trouble, especially with a crazy person like him.
You're not talking about me, are you?
Shut up, Dave.
What's up with this town? Most of the stores are abandoned.
Used to be the center of culture in the Tri-County area. Parties every night at the hotel. Celebrities visiting the Edmund Mansion. It was hard to not make money in those days. Of course, it was before my time. And since the pillow factory burnt down, the town is drying up faster than Dave's sex drive. Ain't that right, Dave?
What's up with the sheriff? He's kind of weirderino.
Yeah, he's kind of a nut job, but nothing compared to the coroner. This whole town has gotten downright weird in the last few years. Cuckooville.
The coroner and the sheriff are the same person.
Well, there might be some resemblance around the eyes, but that's about it. The sheriff does this annoying Areno thing, and the coroner does an annoying a who. It pretty much proves they're not the same person.
Oh, yeah, right.
How does speech prove they're not the same person?
You're asking a lot of questions that probably shouldn't be asked.
I'm a federal agent. That's my job.
I've said too much already.
We're the feds. You can trust us. What else do you know?
Okay, honey. But you didn't hear this from me. I'd look into that crazy clown that lives out at the old circus. He's been out there since the circus closed down years ago. Never takes his makeup off. He's got serial killer written all over him. It all happened about 9 or 10 years ago.
Flashback.
Ransom the Jerk was the featured act at Stupendous Brothers Circus. He was about ready to go on stage and meet his well-earned doom.
Big night tonight. Full house after my raunchiest Tonight Show appearance. I really got Johnny good, that little jackwad. It's his own fault for not being able to take a joke. I better get ready to go on stage and insult the crap out of these thimbleweed idiots. I just need to fix my hair, put on my makeup and clown nose, and find my joke book.
Oh, shoot. I actually jumped storylines to that.
Ouch! That...
Get my beeping joke book back. Close that.
It's my lawyer's business card. It's an IOU. I, Carney Joe, loan ransom the clown. Meanest clown
Man,
of 1977 and 1978. Ransom the clown.
How do I get out of here? Oh.
Ransom. I'm glad I caught you before you went on stage.
Autographs are $100.
Ransom, I'm your business manager and lawyer. I don't want your autograph.
Okay, 50 then.
I just wanted to let you know that your mistress is waiting at your house in Aspen, and your private jet is being fueled and ready to whisk you there when the show is over. Also, we have a deal worth millions to license a line of toddler Ransom the Clown talking insult dolls.
Did he get the liability clause waived?
Correct. They will assume all liability when the kids grow up to be beepholes.
Good. Toddlers start out as... It's not my fault they end up that way.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. $25.
I should have been a dentist.
Yeah. You.
So let's go in here.
It's my lawyer's business card. Brent?
Talk to the mime, that's great.
Well, you. It's my Ransom the Clown swear jar with $138 in it. My contract states that I'm the only one who's allowed to swear. Anyone else come? This goop keeps my clown fro erect. Can't have this goop keeps my clown fro erect. Can't have a limp clown fro or anything else.
Hey. Dude, it's already looking great.
It's my special custom-made clown makeup. I am tired of putting it on every night. It must be that other clown's hat. I don't. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special Ransom clown makeup. I can't go on like this. Get your together, clown. I have a clown nose, but I just look like a drunk. I have a clown nose, but I just look like a drunk. It must be that other clown's hat. I don't wear hats.
This guy, all he does is friggin' cuss. That's funny.
I can't walk in through the main entrance like a tuna-headed pleb. I'm Ransom the
pleb.
We got prizes. You got my money, clowny?
That's Ransom the Clown, asswipe.
Okay, you got my money, Ransom the asswipe clown? 1,000 clams or you're not getting your joke book back. Yeah, serves you right for playing the duckies.
I need my joke book. The crowd's waiting for me.
I told you before, you ain't getting it till I get the $1,000 you owe me for the duckies. Plus... $138 in interest.
Where what? The f- am I gonna get that kind of dough? I have a show to do. $138 in interest, you loan shark. You are putting the squeeze on me.
Not my problem.
So, how's the old ball and chain and kids, huh?
My wife's doing fine, no thanks to you. And so are the 11 kids. But they still cries themselves to sleep every night after that scare you gave them.
Give me my joke book, face.
I told you before, you ain't getting it till I get the $1,000 you owe me for the duckies. Plus, $138 in interest.
Where the f*** am I gonna get that kind of dough? I have a show to do.
Oh, man.
$138 in interest, you f***ing loan shark. You are putting the squeeze on me.
I don't know, Ransom the asswipe clown. Maybe it's in your hidden safe.
You, I'm out of here.
Actually,
you got my money, Ransom the asswipe clown.
You, I'm out of here.
Okay, let's walk away. Is there anything else here? Get $11.38 for Carney Joe. So where am I gonna get money?
Win big today!
That doesn't seem to work.
You got my money, Ransom the asswipe clown.
You, I'm out of here. It's my lawyer's business card. It's an IOU. Ransom the clown lost $1,000 to me, Carney Joe. And I will hold his joke book hostage until I gets paid.
Until I guaranteed to hit something.
All right, let's, where can I get the money?
I don't have time to leave. I don't have time to leave the circus. I have to get ready for my act.
Oh. I wanted to talk to her. Maybe something, I'm missing something here.
It came off the wall.
Oh, okay. Pick up money. Okay, I guess we're going back to pay the dude.
Lots of prizes. You got my money, Ransom the asswipe clown.
I have your money. $1,000.
There we go.
Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, here's your money. Now where's my junk buck?
Wait, are you messing with me? That's only $1,000 and you owe me $1,138, including the interest.
Thought you'd settle for less. Beggars can't be choosers.
Oh, yeah? Well, I choose to hang on to your joke book till I get the full $1,138.
Oh, man.
Now, beggar off. Hey, guaranteed to hit something. Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, here's your money. Now, where's my joke book?
Wait, are you messing with me?
Ah, jeez.
That's only $1,000 and you owe me $1,138, including the interest.
Thought you'd settle for less. Beggars can't be choosers.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I know, I wish I could kill him.
Hang on to your joke book.
Can I?
Gets the full $1,138. Now, beggar off. Grand prize if you could...
My circus poster, featuring the amazing Ransom the Clown.
Just shoot like a man or a little girl.
What can I do?
Just shoot like a man or a little...
I can't use it here. It's an IOU. It's an IOU. Ransom the...
I don't know. It's kind of stuck.
Hey, take a shot at the target.
Can I? I want to play.
Yeah, take a shot at the target.
I would love to play for money. Let's go to the circus ground. Maybe there's more money that I didn't know that's in my trailer. Let's go see. Oh.
Meanest clown of 1977 and 19. I glued him to the table so no one can steal him.
Great.
He's happy where he is. It's a prototype Ransom the Clown doll. It's a perfect likeness of me. Well, my hair is all frizzy and I'm not wearing my special Ransom clown makeup. I can't go on like this. Get your together, clown. My housekeeper does a pretty good job of keeping this place clean.
What else can I do with this?
It's exactly $1,000 in unmarked bills.
It's like nothing. Let's go outside. So something we have to do on the main grounds.
Go yourself.
Give.
Looks fine to me. I can't open that. I'll just take the big bucks.
There we go.
It's exactly
$1,100. Ah, we just jacked money from the swear jar. Okay. It's like, why? It's got to be something here.
Win a fine leather jacket.
money.
Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, well, not much choice. Now where's my joke book?
Finally.
Yeah, the jokes all suck.
Sweet.
So how'd you get to be so famous with jokes like these?
Yeah? What do you know about being funny?
About as much as you do, which is nothing. Now scram, clowny. You're scaring the customers.
Sweet. Right? So we got that. Get my clown fro looking great.
Try your skills.
So let's go mess with my hair. Oh shoot. Yeah. Ew.
Ooh, my clown fro looks great now.
Apply my awesome makeup. Use goddamn makeup. And we're looking good. All
now
right.
There's the face I love.
Okay, I'm going on stage. All right. There we go.
Hello, faces. I'm Ransom the Insult Clown.
Real clown shaved curls.
Easily, and if you do, it's your own fault for not being able to take a joke. You guys love that pillow factory. It's the lamest claim to fame a town has ever had. Paris has the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, we're just insulting the crowd.
Of Liberty.
It's a dude that looks like a pizza.
Park has a pillow factory. You better hope to God that feather pillows never go out of style.
Oh my gosh.
You're all a bunch of inbred freaks. Don't try to deny it, because I've seen the sheriff, the coroner, and the hotel manager. The
That's
low
not
IQ,
what I said.
The weird speech patterns, the same ugly face. If that ain't just one weirdo, somebody definitely their sister.
What the?
Hey, you, kid with a crappy wheelchair. Were you in a past life or something? Seriously, kid, you're in a wheelchair, and you got
real
a
real clowns
like
have
that?
Curls.
God's definitely
oh,
punishing
yeah.
you for
Sorry,
something.
I saw the break in between.
Hey, you, ugly old lady with the hairy mole. Or is it your parasitic twin? Whatever it is, I hope you bought a separate ticket. Because if it's big enough to ride the roller coaster by itself, it's not freeloading in my audience.
Dude, I'm sure. Oh.
You will be forever sorry for what you've just said.
Oh.
I curse you to never be able to remove your makeup and to roam these circus grounds until the end of time.
Oh, that sucks.
He went on for another 2 hours insulting everyone he could. Some people laughed because they thought it was funny, but most laughed because they were uncomfortable, and laughing is the best way to hide from the embarrassment of others. But after the show, in his dressing room, there wasn't going to be any laughter.
Ha! I killed tonight! One of my best shows ever!
You were not actually
I hope that
upset.
Old lady with a curse
I was making
breaks
a joke.
On the way home. Now to get this makeup off, hop on my private jet, and go see my mistress, Cindy, in Aspen.
Yeah, this clown has to go see his mistress. He can't get the makeup off.
What the?
The.
You up the come on.
As much as he tried, his makeup wouldn't come off. That old lady wasn't just any old lady.
Oh, that dude. Oh my god. I'm glad he's like arts. What's he going to do? He can't play Infinity anymore since the servers are
just
done.
Finding out.
Glad that guy was gone, man. Guy's weird. I'm saying he probably had some bipolar thing going on. Oh.
Ransom, I've got some bad news.
What do you want, you bald, greedy little... Can't you see I'm having a problem? Grab a tissue and some rubbing alcohol and help me, you...
Your private jet crashed while trying to land. Your wife found out about your mistress, and she's taking everything you own except the house in Aspen. There was a fire in Aspen, and your house burned to the ground.
Ah.
The toy and doll licensing deal is dead, and they're suing you for breach.
This guy's
and
just going down.
Thing. I quit.
What?
And go beep yourself.
And go beat yourself. Look at that clown's going nuts.
And And that's why Ransom the Clown is such a creep. And you should go arrest him for murder.
That's an interesting story. We'll go check up on him.
Okay, but I need some fingerprint tape.
We interrupt our hostile takeover non-stop music with this important message. The government is brainwashing you with secret transmissions. We just don't know where they are coming from. And now back to our special hostile takeover song.
Okay, that was weird. I need to fingerprint the thing.
That doesn't seem to work.
Let's switch to her.
I need to stay focused.
I have no reason to use. I wonder.
Sorry, but we're out to dinner. Call back next week.
This is some huge freaking phone. Okay, let's see if we could find.
I can't reach that. The doors are. It says, we're out of the old abandoned pillow factory. Back soon. Safely for savings manager, Mr. El Polo. I can't talk to that. I can't open that. It's a bag full of plumber tools.
Let's talk to these guys.
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
Gotta go.
What's up, money?
I've got a murder to solve. It's an odd-looking plumber's wrench.
Can we get it?
Don't touch our Wrenchtron 3000. Only someone like
Wrenchtron 3000. Everything's something 3000.
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
Gotta go. I've got a murder to solve.
Okay, let's move. Oh, maybe there's something here.
The inscription says, Pillowtronics, the brain of our city.
Pillowtronics?
Insert three reports from the Bloodtron 3000, Fingertron 3000, and Facetron 3000 into the Arresttron 3000 to issue an arrest warrant.
Got it. Is there anything here? We need to get tape.
It's already open.
Ugh.
It's a police radio. It's a pretty big vacuum. It's a pretty big vacuum tube. Standard city-issued desk, but the desk has no drawers.
Great. Go here.
It's a medical skeleton. Please return to Dr. Fred.
Oh, wait. I don't remember this.
They must have moved the body from the river. They must have moved the body from the river.
Oh, crap!
Ah, you scare a Reno!
What
me.
The?
I mean, scare a hoot me.
Whatever. What is that creepy violin music?
I have no idea. It comes through the plumbing. Okay, back to sleep-a-hoo.
Yeah.
Better let the coroner sleep. Awarded to Dr. Mort E. Shun by Sheriff Crook.
Mort E. Shun?
Chewy Caramel Center. Ugh. It has the fingerprint book. It's a circus flyer. It's a circus flyer with a crazy looking client. It's a hotel key card from the dead man. Impressive, but nothing happened.
Yeah, okay. I guess we're going down to the city. Uh-huh. These pigeon guys are weird. Walk to the vista.
Whoa there, little Agent Arino. You can't just go bumbling around the county without a map. It's too easy to get lost. There is a Killerino on the loose.
I am a federal agent. I can take care of myself.
And a darn fine agent, I'm sure of. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
A map? Seriously?
Oh, yes, and not just any map, but an official map.
And where would I find this official map?
Well, the county is plumberino out of them. I guess this really messes up your investigation. I'm sure the head office will understand, Arino. Shall I mark the case as unsolved?
Not a chance. The feds never give up.
Dora the Explorer.
Or should I say, the Fed-Arinos never give up.
I see. Now you're mocking me.
Aren't there some donuts that need eating?
Well, you got me there. Ooh, those donuts aren't gonna eat themselves. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
Yeah, you're right.
They won't let me
I'll
go.
I'll head back to town and find a map.
Ooh, donuts do sound good.
Can I just go?
Whoa there, little
Damn
Agent
it.
Arino. Like I said before, you can't just go bumbling around the county without a map.
That's the hotel I have to go to.
Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map.
Ooh, donuts do sound good.
All right, let's go. That was a waste of my time. Maybe at that store I could get a map.
Welcome to Quickie Pal. Can I help you find anything?
Maps.
There aren't any maps left.
Sorry, little dudette. The sheriff came by a bit ago and nabbed all the maps. Didn't even pay for them. Something about immature dominion or something like that.
MLB's done. Sweet.
If I had something to mail, this might work. It's Anne. I'm sorry for forgetting your birthday card. That's sweet.
I'm here to serve.
Great. I'm stuck.
It's
the alley.
ThimbleCon 87. It's opening later tonight at the hotel.
ThimbleCon.
It's the back door to the diner. It's the back door to the diner. What a mess. It's the back door.
Oh crap! I just got whacked! Crap. Did not expect that. Can I get the same? Oh.
Definitely Agent Ray's notebook. I will, of course, refrain from perusing its definitely Agent Ray's notebook. I will, of
Bullseye
course,
Bullseye troll, how are you doing, man? Contents.
Agent Protocol.
Okay, so maybe we could find something here?
Pretty disgusting. Pretty disgusting.
What's
it's an
box?
Empty. It's an empty box. It's the back. It's the back door to the diner. What a mess.
Dude, I think I'm stuck. I guess I gotta go check out all the other alleys and stuff. All right, we can do that. I thought I saw another alley like B Street. Oh shoot, there is another street here, huh?
Filled to the brim with smelly trash. The pet store is for rent. Guess no one around here has any pets.
Cakes! Could have a cake right now. Ricky
hey
Lee.
There. Let's go over to the counter where we can talk. Alrighty now.
Based on your sign, I was kind of expecting this place to be a bakery.
Sorry
this
about
is not
that,
a bakery.
Hon. This used to be Ricky's Cakes, but now we sell vacuum tubes.
Sounds like an interesting turn of events. Anyway, I'm Special Agent Reyes. I have some questions for you.
Oh, pleased to meet you. I'm Ricky Lee, and I'm the proprietor of this little store.
The proprietor
what can
of
I do
store.
For you, hon?
Since you don't sell cakes anymore, what's your store called now?
Not really sure. I've been bouncing a few ideas around since the pivot. I don't suppose you
since
have any suggestions.
Pivot.
Tube-tastic.
Oh, that's a great name. I'm so lucky you wandered in today.
What's
the
this
kindness
about?
Of strangers is amazing.
So
glad
weird.
I could help. That's all for now. Don't leave town.
Okay, hon. Just holler if you need me.
Think she wants me.
It's out of order. The coin.
Huh. Numbers we could talk to. Right? Am I really gonna call all these people? I have no reason to call anybody.
The doors are locked and nobody's inside.
Who's this hooker?
Excuse me, ma'am.
My.
Oh, here we go.
What do we have here?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I don't pay for affection.
Sweetie, I'm not a hooker. Although, there is something about a man in federally mandated polyester that makes me want to forget my wedding vows. I'm Lenore Edmund Mulch of the famed Pillowtronics Edmund family.
I have a feeling it's another story.
I'm waiting for my husband and son to arrive on the bus.
Do you know anything about the body by the river?
Oh, sweetie. Yes. Someone is finally getting rid of it. But one does hear things, and I do have an inkling of who might be connected to this.
Where are you from,
nasty
Bullseye?
Business.
Tell me about Pillowtronics.
Pillowtronics was the brainchild of my uncle, the great entrepreneur and genius inventor, Chuck Edmund. The Edmunds made this town great when we opened the Pillow Factory. My family, even my stupid little sister Dolores, might as well be royalty as far as Thimbleweed Park is concerned, sweetie.
What are you doing at the bus station?
I'm just waiting for my husband and son to arrive, but it seems they will be a while.
Uh-oh.
Maybe you and I could go and get better acquainted in the meantime, sweetie?
Ooh.
Sorry, but I'm working on a case right now, ma'am.
Damn.
Tell me who you think is connected to the body.
Well, I hate to cast aspersions, but
Trollo Reno.
I suppose it is for the good of the town.
Trollo Reno.
You know.
Just like this
actually,
game.
Actually, no, I can't do this. The Edmund reputation is at stake.
Kappa.
Tell me more about Pillowtronics. I heard it closed down because of a fire.
Yes. An incompetent security guard ruined our family legacy with his negligence. But let's talk about something more pleasant.
She wants him.
Ma'am, please tell me what you know.
Fine, it was my sister Dolores. She abandoned our family
what?
And the business to become a...
Call center operative?
No. It was far worse. She became... a video game developer.
What?
It all started a few years back.
Video game developer? What?
Oh. She only wanted one thing. To be a game designer for that awful game company. Mucus Phlegm. Uncle Chuck wanted something else for her, but...
I saw. No. I know your Woody
she
Bullseye.
She was too selfish.
Your Toy Story.
Only wanted to make stupid adventure games.
I've got to get out of this town. Uncle Chuck wants me to program his factory computers, but I just want to design games.
Billy Idol poster.
I wish I could get a job at a company like Mucus Phlegm Games. Now the only thing I have to look forward to is my favorite computer magazine. In fact, I should check the mailbox and see if it's arrived yet.
Find the ideal job. Check the mailbox. Escape from Escape. Okay, let's walk to the door. Clearly, that's not the door.
Hi there, George.
Creepy guy.
I was just about to check the mail.
Smack!
Great timing.
You still around, Dolores? Thought you'd have left this podunk of a town by now.
It's nice for
Chaucer. Yes, hopefully soon. I'm looking for a job at a game company in the big city.
That's not gonna make your Uncle Chuck happy.
He'll just have to deal with it. What brings you all the way out here?
I have your special magazine here.
Oh, I've been waiting.
Who'd ever remember that donkey's name?
Sure, it's what we dedicated government employees do. Walk all the way out into the country to deliver a magazine.
It's Bite Me World, the best computer magazine ever.
Bite Me World!
Wow, an ad for a job at Mucus Phlegm Games, my favorite game company. I hear they make movies, too. Hi, Doug. What are you digging?
All right, Dolores. I'm just digging stuff in the front green. Mostly
digging
holes,
some bodies.
But then I buries them again.
Special mag. It's a special mag.
Okay, Doug. You're doing a good job.
Doug or Dad? Doug?
Digging?
Dial in with modem and fill out. Wow. Mucus Phlegm job application. That's great. References to frickin'... AOL. What's up, Joey? I'm going back in my room. It's an interesting door. Ooh, Joey? What the? What the hell's that? Why does everyone have, like, that weird light above their door? God, that's a big, What's up, man? How you doing?
Oh, excuse me.
How do I get out of here?
Pretty dark in here.
Why is everything so confusing? Oh, here's my room.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64.
Commodore 64?
With dual 1541 floppy drives and a blazingly fast 1200 baud modem. It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64 with dual.
It's a vacuum tube. You're right.
And a blazingly fast 1200 baud modem.
I wonder if that's the one that's that has the vacuum tube thing. Thank you, Irish Strong, Sean.
I'm dialing the Mucus Phlegm modem number.
Watching the Knicks. Nice. Last NBA night right now.
It's connecting.
Oh hey, my modem's connecting. Awesome. I'm applying. I'm just following instructions here.
I can't believe my computer's connected to Mucus Phlegm.
Welcome to the new online Mucus Phlegm job application program.
When things were like new to like hooking up on the internet.
And answer a few simple mucus programming questions. Then print out the application and send it to Mucus Phlegm. We'll get back to you in exactly 5 days. What is your name? Thank you. what is your
Thank
address?
You for the host, Spark.
Noted. Next, what's your programming language of choice? The language you are most proficient in.
Yeah. It's all good, dude.
Very ambitious. We like that. Please answer the following questions about our proprietary mucus programming language.
It's like a real application.
You must get all of the questions right to submit your application.
Okay.
Okay. First question. This is an easy one. Next question. Also an easy one.
She working.
Reference counted. A little
take off
harder.
My shoes. I have my shoes on still.
Ah. Debugging is on a second monitor. Last question.
Okay.
Ouch. This is going to take some thinking. Got it. Exclusive ore.
All right.
Thank you for taking the mucus phlegm programming test. Congratulations. You passed the mucus phlegm programming
test.
Yeah,
I'll be going on tonight.
Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application.
Yay. Look at my printer. It's a freaking typewriter.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64. Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application. Oh, there's no paper in the Printron 3000. I printed my job application, but the page is blank. Maybe the printer is out of ink.
Oh, God, I have to use... Can I eat that pie? Oh, yeah, no problem, dude. You need rest, dude.
This printer ribbon looks all dried out. It won't print anything.
I have to go find some ink? It's like someone answering the door.
That sounds like the doorbell.
Yeah, going to the door, man.
Hi again, George.
It's not like a government employee to make a mistake, but... I forgot to deliver this important letter for your Uncle Chuck.
He's busy in his workshop and can't be disturbed. I'll take it for him.
Okay, Dolores. Here it is. And remember, it's illegal to open someone else's mail.
Great, thanks for the hint.
$50,000 fine and or 5 years in jail.
Thanks, George. That's good to know.
It's all good, man.
Okay,
hey, man, that works.
Vitally important
and get your points.
Job.
Get your moppies. Still don't know why I have like a pie in my bag. I know, huh?
It's a letter to my Uncle Chuck.
Let's open it.
I'd better not open it.
It won't
Uncle
let me
Chuck,
open
the
it.
The fireplace looks very clean.
I wanted to open it. I really did. I'm like, hey. Let's open the cupboard.
There's nothing inside. Pretty clean, considering.
Do I have to go outside to go to where he's at?
Hi, Doug. What are you digging?
All right, Dolores.
Doug's creepy.
I'm just digging stuff in the front green.
Doug.
Mostly holes, but then I buries them again, all neat and tidy.
Okay, Doug. You're doing a good job.
Ta, Dolores!
Doug's doing a good job.
It's very dry firewood.
Where do I go? Can I go down the country road?
Digging?
I can't leave the mansion yet.
This is like Maniac Mansion all over again. Ah, man. I don't feel like wrestling tonight, dog. Sorry, man. Probably next time. Okay. Okay, there's nothing here. Oh, hey. What's this index?
This is Uncle Chuck's Indextron 3000 library filing lookup system. It uses the spewy decimal system to catalog books.
What do I need to know that stuff? You brought your jammies and everything. Look at
Chuck. Chucky's been in our family for years. Chucky's been in our family for years. He's a good plant.
Yeah, let's walk to the staircase.
There's a sign there. It says out of order.
The stairs?
The sign says it's out of order.
That's a staircase. How does a staircase get out of order? There ain't nothing here. Good point. Sticks.
The sign says it's out of order.
Oh my gosh. Okay, where do I go? I'd like to use the pie.
I don't have time to eat pie right now.
What do you have pie in your freaking...
It looks great.
We naked wrestle? Is that what we do these days?
Chucky's been in our family for years.
We naked wrestle. Plant. It is Naked Wrestling Wednesdays. Okay, we know that's my room. I just gotta find this guy's room. Where does this lead to? Oh, there's a cat in there. Oh, why did it bring me back there? Bring me back. It's a shortcut, maybe. What kind of Jordans, dude?
Franklin, you idiot! I'm just trying to, you know, help.
Is that yelling? Don't gag me. I hope my dad and Uncle Chuck aren't fighting again.
And since most of the machinery at the pillow factory is lying fallow, I've come up with this, you know, great plan to repurpose them. We can use them to make, you know, plush toys.
Franklin, you idiot! The company is Pillowtronics, not stupid plush toytronics. We make pillows.
Oh.
What do you think that would do to our credibility, our reputation?
Okay, Chuck, you're right, but
I got some Retro Sixes Olympic ones.
Business plan.
Oh, actually,
maybe
no.
You could
Laker
just,
color
you know,
ones.
Look at it.
No.
I'll put
no,
a picture of it.
No, it's a pillow factory.
Are you two fighting again? I'm getting so sick of
someone
this.
With the hook in the back,
you're
right?
Brothers, take a chill pill. You started the pillow factory together. Won't you ever stop fighting about it?
Nothing you need to worry about, Dolores. Right, Franklin, old brother?
Ah, yes. You know, your uncle and I were just,
definitely,
you know, talking business. I have some work to do.
Dolores, can you get my 0.8mm point-tip soldering iron?
You know, Uncle Chuck, you should use a 2mm flat tip, and you never heat your solder hot enough.
I'll take a picture of it. I had the original ones when I was like in seventh grade.
I can't wait for you to take over the pillow factory. I know you'll keep the Edmund pillow dream alive.
Okay, let's give
Uncle Chuck. I have something for you.
To get the letter.
What is it, Dolores?
I didn't realize my camera cuts off the other choices I could do.
I've been expecting this. I'll deal with it later.
I need to get ink. Wow, you could probably come up on that.
My dear Dolores.
It's Uncle Chuck's custom-built multi-band oscilloscope with phase memory monitoring.
Robot
He's
head.
A work of art. I'm looking forward to playing chess with him.
Oh, Dolores, Dolores, Dolores. How many times
have
I told you not to touch my things? But as soon as you've taken over the pillow factory, they're all yours to do with as you wish.
I knew it. That makes sense. The vacuum tubes and the pillow factory was where I was at.
Uncle Chuck, it's a box, but it's sealed shut. It's a box.
Maybe it's related to that dude.
It's a defunct robot prototype.
Oh, Dolores. How many?
It's a letter to my Uncle Chuck. The stamps haven't. I'd better not open it. Uncle Chuck would know if I read it, if the envelope opened.
Oh, Dolores.
It's a
defunct robot prototype. Uncle Chuck never makes. Uncle Chuck. It's a box, but it's sealed shut.
My dear Dolores, please leave my box alone. You may open it up as soon as you've taken.
It's a TX1138 tube in perfect condition.
Hopefully you get that, dude. Tells
it's a whip made out of network cables. The label says it's called Cat509 Tails, produced by getdigital.e. It's a
that's
whip
what
made
dominatrix
out of network
people
cables.
Use.
The label says it's called Cat509 Tails, produced by get.
Dolores.
Oh yeah, $20 is this. Dude, if you could get like a fat deal, man, ugh. You'd be alright.
Where am I?
It's a good shortcut there. Great. Ooh, action figures. Susie Boy's red
These
gel
are part
decoder.
Of my action figure collection, including my prize,
some
Howard
action
the
figures.
Duck.
I would love to have some action
it's
figures
It's a red
now.
Gel decoder. It's an LFG1982 tube. This printer ribbon looks all dried out. It won't print anything. It's Uncle Chuck's new invention, the Printron 3000. It's connected to my computer. These are part of, I think Revenge of the Jedi was a much better name.
Revenge of the Jedi?
You're a rebel, Billy. Max was the world's first computer-generated TV host. Someday we'll have one for real. Albert's my hero.
Albert Einstein.
I like to keep my bed.
See, I wanna, try this again.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 60. That doesn't seem to work.
Use it.
Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application. Oh, there's no paper in the Printron 3000. There, the blank paper is back in the Printron 3000.
But I don't have ink.
Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application. I printed my job application, but the page is still blank.
Ugh.
Maybe the printer is out of ink.
Okay, where can I jack some ink?
Just down the hall is the... This is Uncle Chuck's Indextron 3000 library filing lookup system. It uses the SPUI decimal system to catalog books.
SPUI decimal system, Here, open every drawer.
There's nothing inside.
What is that?
It's an empty glass.
Go for it,
it's
man.
It's an empty glass.
What's the name? Sticks just got it right
There's
now, too.
There's nothing inside. It's a can of non-trained...
Dude,
what a
mess.
One
messy fridge.
Someone could cut themselves on those bottles. There's nothing inside.
Gross.
Eh.
The application is all filled out. Just have to send it in.
Maybe I could go outside. Not yet. Planning on doing it sometime. I don't even know how to do that. I'll probably make my character and all that.
I can't leave. That's the country road back to town.
Dude, I'm like stuck. It's gotta be a... How do I get ink?
This clock looks vaguely familiar. Maybe more highly rendered and smoother pendulum. The fireplace looks very clean.
Oh, is this from a game? Highly rendered. That is a reference to a video game. Figure that out. Where does this go?
Ouch! No pinching.
No pinching.
Feeling my way along.
Starting miners. That's cool. I gotta totally look into it. I don't know what position. I'd probably want to be a outfielder. That's why I play in softball.
I told you not to touch my things. But as soon as you've taken.
It's a defunct robot prototype.
Oh, Dolores.
It's Uncle Chuck's custom-built multi-band oscilloscope. Uncle Chuck never makes his bed. It's Uncle Chuck's custom-built multi-band oscilloscope with phase... It's a TX-1138 tube. In perfect condition. Ugh. It's a defunct robot prototype. It's Uncle Chuck's old desk. It's turned on.
Oh, Dolores. How many times have I...
Yeah, dude, where to... All I need is... Why? I hate being stuck.
It's my handy ASCII chart. Never know when you'll need to decode binary messages, so I always practice. It's Lurleen, my pet chinchilla stuffy.
Chinchilla?
Dad gave it to me when I was 3 years old. It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64 with dual 1541. It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64 with dual 1541 floppy drives and a blazingly fast 1200 baud modem.
I don't know, man. I got a free Xbox One when I was able to get Darksiders. It was free for Xbox Gold.
These are part of my action figure collection.
I was thinking doing Darksiders. Oh, wait. I think I see something. Oh, freaking. It's a red gel decoder. I don't even know what
it is. It's a red gel decoder.
Nothing here.
It's graphic basic software from Hessware to supercharge my Commodore 64. It says it's by Ron Gilbert and Tom McFarlane. Wonder who they are.
That sounds so familiar. So many references in this game. Look at dry. Okay.
It's an LFG-1982 tube in perfect condition. Uncle Chuck is too cheap to buy ribbons, so he just re-inks the old one. Graphics basic.
Oh!
An enhanced basic.
Oh, I know what to do.
The full potential of your computer.
He has to re-ink that crap. Okay. Took me a while to figure that out. It's like, ah. Where's my uncle? Where my uncle at? Okay, we're gonna give. Okay, we got this.
Look, Uncle Chuck.
Dolores, you know how busy I am right now. Maybe your father would be interested.
Oh.
Hello, my favorite niece.
Where is her father?
Thanks for chatting, Uncle Chuck.
Why don't you practice your ASCII conversion? All my Trons rely on it.
Okay, Uncle Chuck.
Chuck is the one that wants the tubes, I guess. Or I don't know, is that his dad? Her dad wants to do the tubes. Do you have to find her dad's door? I'd be pretty ticked off if I had to do that. Check all these. Oh, never mind.
Just down the hall. Hi, Doug. What are you digging?
All right, Dolores. I'm just digging stuff in the front green. Mostly holes. But then I buries them again, all neat and tidy.
Okay, Doug. You're doing a good job.
Ta, Dolores.
Where's her dad?
Digging.
I can't leave the mansion yet.
I can't leave the mansion yet.
The sign says it's out of order. It says out of order.
Why do I let
him? He is too far away. Uncle Chuck is too cheap to buy ribbons. So he just re-inks the old one. I'd better hold on to this.
Come on!
Uncle Chuck never should have talked to you like that.
He's right. My idea was worthless. I'm worthless.
Dad, I don't like to see you like this. I liked your idea
for the pillow factory.
Chuck thought it was a bad idea, and he's right.
He's never even read it. You need more confidence, and stop letting Uncle Chuck push you around.
Thanks, Dolores. You're a great daughter. But Chuck knows what is best for the factory.
Bye, Dad. I love you.
Goodbye, Dolores. I should stick up for myself.
I'd better hold on to this.
I need him to use it. I need to re-ink that shit.
Uncle Chuck is too cheap to buy ribbons, so he just re-inks the old one. It doesn't last very long.
Never even read it. Okay, let's... go to my uncle that's...
It's the archway leading to the second floor. It's the arch...
All this to re-ink a freaking thing.
Uncle Chuck is too cheap to buy ribbons.
Hello, my favorite niece.
Uncle Chuck, do you have any new printer ribbons?
You know I don't buy new ribbons, I just re-ink them myself. Printer ink is a scam.
Okay.
I didn't get rich by wasting money.
Of course. Thanks, Uncle Chuck. Look, Uncle Chuck.
Dolores, you know how busy I am right now.
Slave.
Maybe your father would be interested.
God! Okay.
Sick of pillows.
Bye, Dad. I love you.
Goodbye, Dolores.
I know. If I was playing hard mode, would be a bitch. I haven't played
Sick
these kind
of pillows.
Kind of games in a long time. No, no, give.
I better hold on to
She just says, oh, come on. Oh, God. You have any hints, Bullseye?
To buy ribbons.
Please?
So he just re-inks the old one. It doesn't last very long.
I mean, God, he's telling me to go to him and...
I better hold on to this. I can't use the printer ribbon with that. The sign says it's out of order.
This is lame. I can't think of any other way to...
It's the archway leading...
Like, how to re-ink this thing. Chuck room. But I was just there. Oh, thanks, man. Better look at the desk. Okay.
I should stick up for myself.
Chucky's been in our family for years. He's a good plant. That doesn't seem to work.
Chuck room. This is Chuck. Oh, wait. Uncle Chuck. What am I tripping? Okay.
The sign says it's out of
order. I am totally in the wrong one. Okay. Gotcha. I'm like, I wasn't thinking. Uncle Chuck. That's what you meant. Shortcut. Like, thinking too much in this game.
It's Uncle Chuck's custom-built multi-band oscilloscope with phase memory monitoring. Look, Uncle Chuck.
Dolores, you know how busy I am right now.
Oh!
Maybe your father would be interested.
Is that ink? Oh. Dude, you're awesome, Bullseye. I am
it's tripping. A bottle of homemade printer ribbon ink. And it smells. That doesn't seem to work. Uncle Chuck is too cheap to buy ribbons.
Wait.
So he just re-inks the old one. I can't use the printer ribbon with that.
Okay.
That should do it.
Oh, you're awesome. Let's get out of here. Skedaddle. Okay, let's go in the room.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64.
Oh,
yay!
Easy.
I answered all the mucus questions
wait, I need
correctly.
To put...
I'm ready to print out the application. Oh,
paper.
The Printron 3000's printer ribbon isn't installed. There, the blank paper is back in the It's my state-of-the-art Commodore
64. Always ransack wherever you play. Okay, gotcha.
Floppy drives and
thank
a blazingly
you. It's been so long.
Fast 1200. Yay! I answered all the mucus
I'm
questions
I'm more of an
correctly.
Action game guy
I'm
now.
I'm ready to print out the application. Oh, the Printron 3000's printer ribbon isn't installed.
Nope.
I can't use the bottle with that. I can't pour ink into the Printron. I have to ink the ribbon. It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64.
You're awesome, dude.
With dual 1541 floppy drives and a blazingly fast 1200 baud modem.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Use it.
Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly.
Print.
I'm ready to print out the application.
Oh, and it's working! You're the man!
I always like to watch this part.
What the? Wow, you even folded up. Sweet! Why can't they have that in real life? We're just... Puts it in the envelope and sends it out. Okay, let's mail it in, man. So we could escape Thimbleweed!
Just down the hall is just down the.
Let's get out of here!
Diggin'!
How exciting!
Yes!
I hope I get the job.
So we're going to get the job 5 days later around 5 p.m. We found Ribbon. Bullseye's helping me, dude. He's cool.
Hiya, Dolores. I have a letter for you.
Sweet. Oh. Escape.
Good luck. See ya.
Digging in the front green.
I think I want to open this in my room. Oh, just geez. In case it's really bad news.
Go back in my room. Leave the room. Go back in the room. Back and forth. I think this is our second story. The first one was a clown, right? The clown story. Okay. Let's like open this.
Now that I'm in my room, I'm still so scared to open it. I need to get up my nerve. Come on, Dolores. You
can
do it. Okay, but if it's a no,
just do it.
I'm stuck in Thimbleweed Park and have to take over the pillow factory. It's a letter from Mucus Phlegm. Did I get the job?
You should just...
Okay, but if it's a yes, what will become of Dad? Stuck here alone with Uncle Chuck. It's a letter from Mucus Phlegm.
Okay!
Did I get the job? Okay, but...
I was like,
okay, I'm opening it.
Yes, you got it. Get out of there. There you go. Good job,
it's a
lady.
A job offer from Mucus Phlegm to be a game programmer. I'm so excited. Can't wait to tell Uncle Chuck. He'll be so proud. But first...
Yeah, you go, girl. You do that moonwalk. As if this game was in the 80s. Yeah! Yeah, you shake it. Yeah, shake it! Wow, how long is this sequence? Dude, she is happy. I guess I'd be doing the same thing too if I got a job. A new job. But my job's cool right now.
I can't wait to tell Uncle Chuck about my job.
Okay. Let's go to Uncle Chuck. Windmill. I know, do a windmill. It's a B-girl. Yes. Pop and lock, bitch. Okay, let's go here. He's gonna get mad.
Hello, my favorite niece.
Uncle Chuck, great news.
Yes, Dolores, what is it, my dear future leader of Pillowtronics?
Oh.
Here, read this.
Nope. She's not going to be the leader of Pillowtronics.
You're what?
Uh-oh.
You're giving up the opportunity to run Pillowtronics to be a game programmer?
Hell yeah.
Yes, that's what I've always wanted to do. Not run Pillowtronics.
Uh-oh.
I'm leaving on the first bus out of Thimbleweed Park.
Then, Dolores, you are out of my will.
Wow.
You're giving up over $10 million. That's $20 million in 2017 dollars. Just to pick an arbitrary date in the future. You are dead to me.
Oh, what a punk. Get out of there.
Dolores broke Uncle Chuck's heart and started programming those murder simulators. Real life murder is the next logical step for her, sweetie. Stop her before she schemes her way into sweet
Stop
Uncle
her.
Chuck's inheritance.
Sure, we'll get right on that.
Come back and see me soon,
Damn,
sweetie.
She wants me, dude. She wants
Ciao.
Me. All right, man. I'm going to have to save this. Wait, is it saved? Okay, cool. All right. I got to go eat some dinner. Din-din. Yeah. We'll close that off. And, yeah, I will probably come back to this later on. I am, like, really into this game. It's pretty cool. I like it. But, yeah, I will be on in about an hour and a half. I might switch it up a bit to Darksiders, I think. And, I don't know. I might go back on the Switch or something. I don't know. We'll do something later on. I'll be on for sure. So, guys, thanks for tuning in. I will see you guys in a short while. Break time. Later.